Hi, today we're going to talk about racket head speed and where it's important. You know, there's so much emphasis on racket head speed today, but where the racket head speed occurs is what's most important. Now, a lot of people get wrapped up, pun intended, on getting racket head speed by releasing the swing from the wrist, by doing this. And I don't know if you can hear this or not, but when I do this, the racket head speed actually occurs over here by my left ear. The same thing happens on the backhand side. People talk about releasing the wrist here to get racket head speed. Well, the racket head speed over here isn't going to do you any good. What's going to do you good is getting racket head speed where it counts the most, at the point of impact. So to get racket head speed at the point of impact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start the racket high. As the racket falls, it's going to pick up speed. There's actually a mathematical equation to this. The racket picks up about 5.5 miles an hour on the first foot of the drop. After that, you get 5.5 times the square root of the height of the drop. Now, that may sound a little bit complicated, but really, if I have a 4-foot drop, the square root of 4 is 2. 2 times 5.5 is 11. So I get 11 miles per hour on a 4-foot drop. So it's not about getting racket head speed here. It's not going to do you any good. It's about getting racket head speed here, and that will equate to racket speed here at the point of impact where it matters the most. So parents, teachers, children out there, remember, it's not about doing this. It's about doing this.